Okay, perfect. So let's start. So welcome everyone. My name is Grégory Bauticure. I'm the product manager for SAP Business Object Web Intelligence. And I'm really glad to be with you again in order to share with you what you can expect in the near future for SAP Business Objects. So let's say that for the next 28 minutes, you're going to get all the details. The presentation is in two parts. The first one is all about why should you go and adopt SAP Business Objects BI 4.3. And the second part is all about the short-term innovation we're going to deliver to all of you. So first slide. Yes, this is a quick reminder. So SAP is committed to continue to invest into the on-premise BI suite. The 4.3 is proof that you're going to continue to invest into your favorite reporting solution, and the SP2 contains a lot of great innovations for all of you. So why should you go and adopt the BI 4.3? Several reasons for this move. What you have on the screen right now is the three main pillars that contain the main innovation you work on for the BI 4.3. And in my point of view, and you will agree with me, the main reason why you should go with 4.3 is for the pillar in the middle, the user experience. For all your end users, you have great innovations in the area of user experience, and we did this on purpose in order to really to increase the adoptions of your favorite reporting tool into all your department. The second pillar is about hybrid. This is for the customers who are looking for the possibility to reuse all their existing business objects content. So you have to understand for this their existing universes and the data stored into Web Intelligence with SAP Analytics Cloud, which is another solution proposed by SAP for the customer interested by the cloud. And the pillar number three, enterprise readiness. This is everything related to how can you update, install smoothly the BI 4.3. But let's focus on the main pillar, the user experience. So like I said, inside the BI 4.3, your end user will find new interfaces in order to help them to get the existing content, but inside a new, simplified and modernized experience. So what you have on the screen is a new BI Launchpad. This is the BI Launchpad that you will get inside the BI 4.3, and you will get only this one, the BI Launchpad that you are all using today. The 4.2, for example, is not part of the BI 4.3. But the good thing is only the interfaces is new. All your existing content, all your existing deployment will remain exactly the same. So this is also true, for example, for all the security and authentication you might have put in place in 4.2. Going from 4.2 to 4.3 can be a simple update for you if you want. And what can I say in addition to that? The BI Launchpad in 4.3 is almost on parity with what you have in 4.2. And inside this new BI 4.3 Launchpad, you're going to find a new Web Intelligence. This is a new Webby client for the viewers and the designers. The interface has been completely revisited. It has been created in HTML5, it works on all modern devices, such as a touchscreen, for example. You can play with Webby with your finger if you want. This new client is available for the web, but also for the desktops, which means that you have exactly the same experience on the web and inside the new Webby rich client in 4.3. You will find exactly the same capabilities that what you have in 4.2. Advantages of this one, you don't have to maintain, support the Java runtime because you get rid of this Java, the JVM, the Java Virtual Machine on all your desktop because of the HTML5 technology. And yes, the interface is completely, really, really new, modern, simplified, and we did this with expectations to really to unlock the end user autonomy, increase the self-service supporting and dashboarding. That's really true with this new interface. The end user is really autonomous and you can move from the reporting concept to the dashboarding area with this new tool. Another thing we need to get in for the tree is a Webby data model. So this is completely new for the tree. This is for user ability to reuse all your existing Web Intelligence document to create something new. Why did you do that? Today, when you create a new Web Intelligence document, you have to use Universe. Universe is created by IT, maintained by IT. This is one version of the tool. You will find main information into universes. But we noticed that a piece of information created by your business user is created not in the universes, but inside the Webby document. We call this the business semantic. This is everything a business user is created to answer specific business questions. And here comes the idea that maybe this kind of business semantic should be exposed, and we should allow users to reuse this business semantic to create new Web Intelligence documents. So that's what we did. So everything you have in one Web Intelligence document, such as query number one, which can be a universe, synchronized with a query number two, which can be an Excel file, synchronized with a query number three, which can be, I would say, SAP HANA information. So this gives us a lot of dimension measures and, of course, variables that your business user will have created. And all these kind of informations can be exposed and reused to create a new Web Intelligence document. So we call this the Webby data model. And this is really powerful because it changed completely the game, because you can now let your end user reuse business information created by their colleagues to create new informations. And if they do that, we keep things in synchronization, which means that if you create a new Webby document on top of a Webby data model, if you update the Webby data model, this updates will be pushed into all the Webby document using this Webby data. So this is really Gregory, powerful. Yes.
Sorry, we have a quick question. Somebody asked in the user's desktops, do we update the client tools from 4.2 to 4.3, or do they need to uninstall the 4.2 tools first and then install from scratch? What would you recommend as best practice?
Practically speaking, this really depends on the size of your deployment. But if you want to do something really safe, I would say that you should do something in parallel. So start from scratch a new BI 4.3 deployment and move the content from 4.2 to 4.3.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, that's the Webby data model as part of the BI 4.3. Next argument to move to the 4.3, timeline, I would say. The end of mainstream maintenance for the BI 4.2 is end of 2022, which is almost tomorrow. And this gives us not so many times to start to consider an update or an upgrade to the BI 4.3 that is going to be supported at least until end of 2027. And at this stage, today, we do not exclude to push the boundaries of the mainstream maintenance and the end of support of the BI 4.3 way beyond 2027. We have discussion about that and we are working on this. Other things that you have to know if you decide to move from 4.2 to 4.3, few capabilities are not part of the 4.3. You have the list here. So today, the version available to all of you is the service pack one for 4.3. And here is a list of functionalities that are not part of the 4.3. Shared element, SAP HANA Online, extension point, FreeZider, send to FTP, and so on and so on. They are not in the 4.3 service pack one, and you're going to get them inside the 4.3 service pack two, which is planned, the size pack two of 4.3 is planned for end of this year. And I'm going to detail what you can expect into this one. Excuse me. In a few seconds. Other thing why you should consider the 4.3 is because of our partner need for this. Today, we position Webby as ad hoc query and interactive reporting and dashboarding. But if you decide to adopt the add-ons developed by our partner need for this, really, you can transform Web Intelligence into a data visualization and data exploration tool. So this is at your disposal today. And the visualizations proposed by our partner are really, really powerful, and they integrate all nicely into your existing Web Intelligence document. I really encourage you to have a look at their solution because really, it simply changed the game. Excuse me. You can really now transform Webby into a visualization tool and data exploration tool if you want. And last but not least, we are in 2021, and most our customers using Webby on-prem business object on-premise today have some kind of cloud expectations. And SAP has decided to put in place a program which is called Private Cloud Edition, PCE, which is a program at your disposal today if you want to go from on-premise to the cloud. And what do? Simply, you have to contact your favorite account executive, SAP account executive, and mention this program to them. And what you will do is you will take your on-premise deployment and put it into the cloud, take your on-premise licensing and transform it into a subscription licensing. And they will propose you different t-shirt size for the deployment, small deployment, medium deployment, large deployment. They will propose you an update of your cloud deployment once per year if you want, and so on and so on. But for you, what you have to keep in mind is if you want to go to the cloud and having a subscription model by reusing your on-premise things, by on-premise thing, I mean your on-premise deployment, business object with all your existing universes, Web Intelligence documents, security in place, authentication, and so on. This is available today. You have already some great success with this program. Many customers decide to work with SAP or one of their favorite partners to take their existing content and put it into the cloud. Okay, that's all I wanted to share with you regarding the first part. And now let's have a look at what you can expect inside the 4.3 size pack 2. So this is a preview. Once again, the Service Pack 2 for Business Object 4.3 is planned for December this year, December 2021. I'm going to share with you what you can expect. Because this is a preview, please bear in mind that things can happen, meaning that what I'm sharing with you today, we are in the middle of the development of this Service Pack 2, depending on some time constraint or quality, things I'm going to share and present to you today might not be part finally of the final release of the Service Pack 2. Okay, first thing, Freeze Header. So Freeze Header is not something new. This is something that already exists in the 4.2, but finally, it makes it in the Service Pack 2 4.3. 4.3 Service Pack 2, and it works exactly in the same way that in Service Pack, it works exactly in the same way that in BI 4.2. But instead of showing you and explaining you, maybe the best way is to see a short video explaining how it works. So this is a 4.3 interface, Webby, and you have on the screen a Web Intelligence 4.3 document. By the way, I forgot to mention it, but all your existing Webby documents will behave exactly the same in 4.3. So now I'm going to action this freeze header capability. So I'm going to freeze some headers. I can decide to the number of rows that will compose my header. In my case, I select one row for the header. Done. And now by scrolling down, like in 4.2, my header will remain available for this very long table when I scroll down. Now it works exactly the same way. It works at the view time, but also at the design time. You see the experience at the view time. There's another way to activate it just by clicking at the top item in the menu bar to activate or unactivate it. That's another way to enable it. Okay, that's the freeze header. Another things we're going to get in the Service Pack 2 is the BI 4.3. And for this one, this is really a new innovation. This is the ability to hide a report. in a static way or in a dynamic way. What does it mean? It means that in a web intelligence document, you can decide to show hide a report for your end users. And you can decide to show report based on a specific condition. For example, let's say you create a profit and loss report and you are monitoring a specific KPI inside the P&L report, and suddenly this KPI is moving down and you would like to provide additional things to your end user, you can decide to show a specific report that will help the end user to understand why this KPI is negative quite easily. So once again, here a video will better explain. So this is a web intelligence document. I'm going to enter the edit mode, and let's say that I would like to hide the raw data report. So to achieve that, I just have to click on hide, show hide. A small icon will be attached to the report, and now this is a static on off, I would say, in the report. So now moving back to the view time, the raw data report has disappeared. Right, as you can see, there is no way I can access my raw data report now. So let's go back into the edit mode. The raw data report appear back. And now let's make it not static, but dynamic, which means that I would like to show hide this report, not in a static way, but in a dynamic way. So for this, I would like to use a specific formula. So I have to uncheck the hide always flag and select the second one, which is based on the formula. And here you have the ability to create a formula by showing the formula language, the formula editor. And here everything is supported, right? You can do an if then else statement if you want. The important thing is that you have to know is that the output of this formula should be true or false. That's the way it works. So let's create a dummy formula. If sell revenue is above this amount, show me the report or hide the report. So you validate the formula. You have a new flag here that shows that the report will be evaluated based on the formula. Now you go back into the view time. Okay, the output of the formula is true. So it's false. So in this case, the raw data report is hidden. And of course, if I change the formula, the report will appear depending of this condition. Okay, should I do it? Yep, here we go. So dynamic show hide or not of a report inside Web Intelligence. Okay, another innovation, this concerns the presentation mode. This is not something new, that's something that you have introduced in Service Pack 2, Service Pack 6, if I'm right. This is for you, the ability to take a report and make it on a very big screen and make it refresh automatically. We have decided to add additional capabilities as part of this presentation mode. For example, the ability to select which report should be part of the presentation mode, or to switch from report number one to report number two every, for example, 2 seconds, etc., etc. So once again here, a demo will be better than the slide. So this is a nice web intelligence document with several reports. And here I decided to activate the presentation mode. I'm going to switch between the report every 3 seconds. And I would like to display not all. you can select several Webby reports. So I've selected not all of them, but some of them. And now by moving and activating the presentation mode, I'm going to switch every 3 seconds to the report I've selected. So I'm going to KPI, format series, bar width, waterfall, etc., etc. And it's going to start again with the first one, GeoMaps. Here we go. And of course, as part of the options, you can decide to display the name of the report or not. This is part of the new options at your disposal. Okay, another small improvement as part of Webbit Engine, this is for all the warning messages. Inside Spark One, when you have a lot of warnings, you get a list of warning messages that can be cumbersome because they are cumulative. So now, as part of the BI for the tree, okay, let me do something. I would like to use my laser pointer. Instead of getting this list of warning, you can just factorization of the different warning. And if you click, for example, of the seven, you get the details of the seven warning message. To enable this kind of behavior, there is one option in the properties of your Webbit Engine interface. Okay, another small improvement. This one is all about the charts. We have a new trade chart plan for the tree size pack 2. A trade chart is, for example, you have a nice area chart and you'd like to replicate the same area charts by using another dimension, which can be, for example, country and region. And that's what you have on the screen here. So this new chart, trade chart, will repeat the same area chart based on the different number of occurrences we have for friends and region. Shared element. Okay, the shared element, they are back. I would say they were still available in the Service Pack 3 SP0 and Service Pack 1. What is back in the 4.3 Service Pack 2 is the interfaces to update, edit, create shared elements. So let me be right. If you have already, or if you plan to go directly for 4.2 so to Service Pack 1, to the 4.3 Service Pack 1, and if you have used shared elements in your Webbit Engine document, they will still be there, which means that all the shared elements will behave normally. But there is no way that you can access the shared element in order to create a new one or edit them or update them because the interfaces are not there simply in Service Pack 1. So in Service Pack 2, the ability to access your list of shared elements, the ability to update, create new shared elements is back. So once again, a short video will be better than the slide. So let's have a look at the new shared element side panel and how it works. How can I do? I would like to disable my, here we go. Okay, so this is the Webbit Engine document. We're going to enter in edit mode, and in edit mode, what you have currently on the screen here is a new shared element side panel. So here you are looking at one shared element, SAP logo, which is available in more than one report in the same Webbit document. So that's what the video is showing you, which means that by selecting the name of the report for this shared element, you're going to go and navigate into your Webbit Engine document. So now let's create a shared element. So here I'm going to select this geo map and create a new shared element. So for this, you do a right click, create, save as shared element. You have the shared element dialog box, which open. You select your favorite folder to store and save this new shared element. I'm going to give it a nice name, GeoMaps. One, save, and here we go. So now you have created a new shared element. So now let's use it. So for that, let's create a new report. Let's add a new report inside this Webby document. Okay, let's select it and let's insert it. So for this, you create insert shared element. Here we go. And now you have access to the list of all your existing Webbit Engine shared elements. So that's pretty new. So now I'm going to select the recently created GeoMap shared element. I'm going to insert it into this new Webby report. Here we go. And if you look at on the right, the shared element side panel, you can see that in addition to the SAP logo, now I have a new shared element GeoMap, which is part of the report 15, which is what I've just do right now. Okay, that's a new way to interact with your shared elements, which means that if you go from 4.2 to 4.3, and if your Webbit Engine document contain existing shared elements, the side panel on the right will contain automatically all the shared elements that you have in your Webit Engine document automatically for you. No question about that. But the way to interact with them is slightly, a little bit slightly different compared to for the two.
Gregory?
Yes.
We do have one question on shared elements, and yes, it is, can they be used from one Webby document to another or only within the same Webby document?
Shared element, well, what you have on the screen is when you have, okay, let me have a look, a shared element that when you, the shared element panel will only display the shared element used in the existing, the open Webby Engine document. Okay, if the same shared element used in another Webby document which is closed, not open, you won't see it, right? You won't see only the shared element used in current Webby Engine document, the one being open. Is it clear? Oh, let me have a look at the questions, the chat. For the Q&A, can a shared element be used from one Webby document to another or only within the same? Oh, no, no, the question is different. No, a Webby Intelligence shared element can be used in several Webby Intelligence documents. That's the purpose of the shared element. Okay, so I move on, still have 5 minutes left. So Webby shared element, which client? So we have a new, of course, a Webby Intelligence shared, which client for the tree, but in the service pack 2 of the 4.3, we have some more additional improvements, which are the ability to use the text and Excel files, not the one being saved as part of the BI Launchpad. No, your local text and Excel file can be used with a Webby rich client. And you can delegate the refresh of your existing Webby document to the backend, to the Webby, no, to the business objects backend. So that's a small improvement. We have another set of innovations which are all about the ability to use our data and Google Drive. So let me explain. As part of the size pack 2 of BI4.2, we are working on two important improvements. The first one, we were looking for a new way to create web services for Webby engines. For those of you who are using query as a web services and document as a web services, which are available in 4.2, if you go to directly to 4.3 size pack 1, you won't find the functionality to create a new web services or to edit an existing web services. The functionality are not there in 4.3 Service Pack 1. But your Web Intelligence document based on this technology, so query as web services and document as web services, will continue to work as is, first thing. Starting 4.3 Service Pack 2, we'll propose capabilities that will replace query as a web services and document as a web services. We will propose new way to generate not a SOAP web services, but an OData flow. So that's the first improvement. Query as a web services and document web services will be enhanced to generate not a SOAP web services, but an OData web services, first thing. So you'll be able to generate an OData flow. And on the other side, you will be able to consume in Webby an OData flow, right? OData as a source. Second innovation, you will be able inside Webby to connect, to create a kind of bridge between Webby and your favorite Google Drive. Once we have done that, it means that you will be able to, for example, consume a Google spreadsheet as a data source for Webby engines. If you store a CSV style or an Excel file or a TXT file into your Google Drive, Webby will be able to see them and consume them as a data source. And of course, you'll be able to export to Google Drive via the scheduler. So let me explain currently how it's going to work. So let's talk about first the old data. First of all, that's the new interface, how it's going to work, right? It means that inside Webby Engine document, an existing Webby document, if you want to create an old data flow for the query on the right side in the list of available objects. When you will create the query, you will be able to copy old data web service link, as simple as that. On the other side, when you will select an existing block, a block can be a table, dimension measure variables, or a chart, you will do right click, copy link as old data web services, and that's it. That's the way you're going to generate an old data flow. On the other hand, when you will create a new web application document, you will get a new kind of data provider, which will be OData or web services data provider, that will be able to consume the OData flow you have created or any OData flow generated by, I don't know, any third-party tool, for example. For the Google Drive, it will work more or less the same. So it means that you will be able to authenticate towards your favorite Google Drive, thanks to OAuth technology. Once you will have done that, everything that you have put inside your Google Drive, such as a Google spreadsheet, text file, Excel file, will be visible, and you will be able to consume them to create a web intelligence document on top of them. So it changed a little bit the game, right? And on the other hand, you will be able to export automatically content into your Google Drive, thanks to the scheduler, which means that if you take an existing web intelligence document, schedule it every morning, every week, and decide to export this web document as a PDF, for example, the PDF output can be put into your Google Drive automatically if you want. If you want to do the same, but directly from Webby, this won't be available directly. You will have first to export your Webby document as an Excel, a PDF, HTML, TXT, or CSV file, and then do the upload directly from your local drive to your Google Drive. Okay, so that's what I mean regarding the new data sources. So we have two new entry, a Google Drive entry to select the content of your Google Drive when you have created the bridge between Webby and your Google Drive, and the web services here, the OAuth data, which is here, that will let you consume any OAuth data flow from generated by any third party tool. Okay, that's a quite strong innovation for you. So the ability to consume OAuth data and generate OAuth data flow. And the second one, the support of Google Drive as a data source. Another thing you are working on, this is the usability. You have you have two query panel in for the two. One query panel to consume universes, UNV, with document, Webby document, SAP BW and SAP HANA. And the second that query panel to consume Excel file, TXT file, free and SQL. They have many differences between these two query panel in terms of capabilities. The idea behind this is starting for the free size pack two, you will get only one query panel for all the different kind of data sources, and there will be no differences in terms of capabilities now. So for example, this new query panel will be able for UNV, UNIX, SAP, blah, 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 all your local flat file, et cetera, et cetera. But you will be able to do additional things such as change the aggregation, rename the dimension, rename the measure if you want, and so on and so on. We have small usability enhancement for the prompt and the input control. This is small things that I will let you discover. We have a new format painter. If you want to copy paste the same formatting on top of multiple charts, for example, a new date time picker for the prompts, but also for the input control. What do we have? Hyperlink to generate open document for a specific document. This is back in for the three, so it's back two. This is more one additional usability enhancement. The SDK, we did not forget it. So all the new things I just mentioned will have an equivalent as an SDK functionalities. This is, I would say, mandatory, I would say. Quickly, two last slides. The date, the size pack two for the three is planned end of this year, so December 2021, with the being for the three being supported at least until 2020, 2027, and at this stage we do not plan to extend it. And the roadmap, after the size pack 2, we will have a size pack 3 and size pack 4 and other things that you are working on currently, with a list of strong innovations that you have on the screen right now, for example, with the support of highlighting in Webby, trend lines, dataset exploration via facet inside the new data manager, and some great things that we'll be happy to share with you later on. Okay, I think I've used more time than I should have. I would like to thank you for your attention. The slide will be shared with all of you. And if you have questions, don't hesitate to contact me.